Hello guys, happy Friday and welcome to my live today. Switching it up this week, trying a Friday instead of a Thursday, and yeah, just seeing how it goes. So today I'm going to be talking about common health problems that we have, and I did a little post yesterday to ask what are your health issues or what struggles do you have around your health. And it's more like struggles like how to exercise regularly, how do I put that into my life, struggles of smoking, you know, overcoming that, struggles of also making health a priority, and also just being in tune with your body as well and your health. So really I'm going to be covering these topics and a couple more in the live today. So the first one I'm going to go into, it's a big juicy one. It's just making health a priority in your life, because all of us have a potential to be super duper healthy, no matter what our DNA is, no matter what our family history is in terms of diseases and, you know, being unhealthy, being obese, having heart problems, having cancer. Just because someone in your family bloodline has had it doesn't mean you're going to have it. And we have ultimate control over our health. We're the ones in control and we can literally change it. And, you know, even if your health isn't 100% right now, just know that you can do it. So the first thing I'm going to say here is ask yourself, where are you at right now in your health? If you want to make health a priority and you're not quite doing it right now, where are you at right now? So, I don't know, you tell me, or write it down, where are you at in your health? And also then write out where you want to be. What kind of shape can you visualize yourself being in? And if you can't visualize it right now, because I know it's quite hard for a lot of people to visualize being in optimal health, just try your best to visualize who you want to be or what you want to look like or how you want to feel. Like, that's a really powerful one. So alongside what your health is like right now, how do you feel right now? And then how do you want to feel as well? And then again, like, how do I want my life to be as well? Because prioritizing your health is going to take effort, and the effort is going to be a lot more intense at the very beginning than it will be months and years down the line. The amount of effort is going to get less and less and less as you start to improve your health and just feel better, and you'll get in your flow with it as well. By the way, hi guys, I know a couple of you are watching. Hi Dean, good to see you, hope you're all well. Just really asking yourself how you want to feel again. And it's all about starting small and making choices. And the thing is, with health and with anything like this, there are so many decisions that you need to make, and we end up getting decision fatigue. It's like, you know, when you go out and you want to eat out at a restaurant and you don't know which restaurant you want to eat at, there's so many choices, you're going to get decision fatigue, and then you end up taking ages choosing, and then you're umming and ahhing. So you want to eliminate that and just have like black and white, yes or no, what you're going to do. So I'm going to just visualize, or put this into a visual of choices and how our choices really do affect our goals and where we want to be. So basically, got my little chart, my whiteboard out. So yeah, just saying, everything is a choice. Let's say your goal is here. Okay, that's your goal. Sorry guys, let me just move over. That's your goal. You want to be here, but you are here right now. So that's you. Okay, so you want to get up there. You need to make, probably to get there, you're going to have to make so many choices, the right choices this is. So let's say you've got all of these choices to make. And let's say it takes you 6 months. Ooh, lost my pen, sorry. What was it, guys? Let's say it takes you 6 months to get there, okay? To get to where you want to be. This is where you're at right now. Every decision you make is either going to get you higher up that line, or it's going to get you lower, okay? Or a decision can get make you just sustain plain sailing. I hope that's making sense. So let's say between now and 6 months, you're going to have, what's that, 30 times 6. That's going to be about 180 days times about by 10 decisions a day and a little bit more. Let's say you're going to have to make about 2,000 choices within that 6 months. That's a lot of choices, okay? So you're going to have to eliminate some decisions by just making it black and white, like I said before, okay? So, right, am I going to eat pizza tonight, or am I going to eat rice with chicken and broccoli? Okay, so it sounds a bit boring, but you get the gist. Like, get, you know, plan ahead, get your healthy meals, and just keep this visual in mind of, like, where do I want my choices to lead me? Do I want them to lead me up this path to where I want to be, my goal? Or do I want it to keep fluctuating, going up and down, up and down, up and down? Because that's not really going to get you to where you ultimately want to be. So once you really, really fully take control of your choices that you're making, you will get there, trust me. You just have to have faith and trust in the journey and that your choices are really going to get you to where you want to be. Because so many of us will say that we've tried dieting before, we've tried being at our optimal health before, we've tried working out regularly before, and it just hasn't worked. Like, I don't lose weight, I don't get to where I want to be. But the truth really, really is that you just haven't put in all the effort, or you haven't made as many of the choices to lead you up that path. So I'm hoping, yeah, that makes sense. But again, it's all about choice and deciding, again, what is in my best interest? What do I ultimately want? And am I willing to sacrifice short-term gratitude for my long-term health? Because essentially, we all want to feel vibrant, we all want to have energy, and we all want to just feel good in our everyday lives. And it's hard, but visualize it, and then eliminate those choices so you don't have that decision fatigue, and then you can start really, really just climbing up that ladder slowly but surely in whatever you want in life. Okay, so I think that's kind of my little spiel on making health a priority. And the next thing that was linked to that, somebody asked, how do you get in tune with your body and how can you actually start listening to your body more and be in tune with it? And I feel, for me, like, I never used to really be in tune with my body, not half as much as what I am now. And obviously through years of exercising and, you know, eating different foods, going in phases of dieting and then not eating what I want, you know, all of this kind of cycle, I've learned to really just listen to my body now and actually just decide where I'm happy at with my body. Am I happy being a little bit on the bigger side? And I think, you know, for me personally, I have my own choice with that and I'm happy as I am. But, you know, it's just all about where you want to be right now and listening to your body. Just, you just need to feel it. You need to feel into it. So in the morning when you're waking up, you can ask yourself, how do I want to feel moving into my day? You know, often, like, you might wake up wanting toast and coffee, but is that really going to serve you? Are you going to be hungry in the next 2 hours, you know? Or do you think, I know, I'm going to fuel my body, I'm going to be putting in nourishment into my body by making a smoothie instead, and that's going to fill me up for longer. So through that, it's just listening to your body. What does it need? And more often than not, it will need nutrients. And the more nutrients we give it, the more light in our body, the more, like, the higher the vibration our bodies will be. And with that higher vibration within our physical 3D bodies, we are going to be able to tap into and be more intuitive with our bodies at the same time. So nourishment equals more intuition. Nourishment equals making better decisions, because your body is going to thank you. Whenever you nourish your body, it goes into every cell of our body. So just imagine, like, when you're eating a piece of fruit or you're eating a vegetable or whatnot, or even a healthy curry, just imagine that nourishing your body and just listening out for, you know, am I feeling bloated? You're likely not. And then when you are having a different kind of meal, which is a bit more starchy maybe, or a bit more wheat based, am I feeling bloated? Okay, likely yes. If you are, then, you know, no for next time. Okay, if I still want to have this, I'll just have a little bit and switch up the ratio of things, because ratios can be really, really important. And I'm going to touch on this a bit later with another question of just literally switching up the ratio of, you know, if you have this much spaghetti and this little veg going with it, and you end up feeling quite bloated, or you just don't feel good after the meal, you feel really tired, how about switching it up so you've got this much veg and then you got a smaller portion of spaghetti, so you still have the meal but you'll end up feeling a lot better afterwards, because you've literally just decided to literally change the portion sizes of each element in meal. So so with that is just, we've all had it where we're craving something, we're craving sugar, we're craving chocolate, and we're trying to listen to our bodies, but our bodies are telling us we want something sweet. And more often than not, it's some kind of deficiency in the body. So what I will say with this, it's a more kind of practical answer of, like, are you taking enough nutrients? Are you having enough vitamins and minerals and through your food? And if you're not through your food, then are you taking it through a supplement? And I'm not really that big on supplements. You know, they have to be really, really clean supplements. Personally, I wouldn't go to Holland and Barrett and buy their branded supplements because of the ingredients in them, or even just the ingredients of the shell or the casing. I would just make sure, if you are going to get supplements, do get like an all-in-one or a couple of different ones, like fish oil tablets and then an all-in-one vitamin from a very good kind of brand, or go to a health food shop. But when you start, my point is, like, when you start taking these supplements, your body is gonna have more nutrients and more minerals of what it really, really needs. And that's when the cravings start to really go down, and you can start being in tune with, you know, are you hungry? Is it just boredom? Is it just because I'm feeling a little bit low? Is it because I'm due on my period? Like, all this stuff. And then being more in tune, honestly, guys, when you're more nourished, again, going back to nourishment, you will just be more in tune with your body. So I know it's a bit of a self-fulfilling prophecy, like the more crap you eat, the less in tune you're going to be with your body. So really, you've just got to start taking action by eating nourishing foods. And instead of focusing on being on a diet, put your focus into actually nourishing your body. I should just put a sign in my kitchen saying, like, nourish your body, because I think, honestly, the more veg, the better. Just get them on the plate, half a plate of veg, and you're good, like, really. And then it's just, you know, being in tune with your body. And if you are not in tune with your body right now, and you're just kind of feeding it stuff that, where you're not really feeling good, but you're not as aware as you could be, just know not to feel ashamed, not to feel any guilt around that, because that shame and guilt is only going to weigh you down energetically, and you're not going to feel in the right headspace maybe to get yourself feeling better. So just bear that in mind. Like, we don't have time for guilt and shame around here. Literally, just if you've eaten, I don't know, a whole bar of big chocolate, just get over it, because, you know, there's always tomorrow, or there's always the next moment where you can just start again, or just keep going on a different trajectory. Okay. Right. So moving on to finding time for me, I think I'll address this one next. I'm going to talk about smoking as well, but I'm going to leave that for the last question, just because I feel like this question now ties in better with what has just been said. So yeah, finding time for me. Me time is so hard at the moment. So yeah, just finding time. I know this certain person has a family as well. She's got two children and it's really hard to find time with a family, let alone, you know, if you're on your own and you don't have those kind of commitments, then, you know, you still make excuses, you know, but when you have a family, it's a lot harder. And you know, I can't personally imagine it, but okay, like my best advice really would just be to be realistic with yourself. And again, don't be harsh on yourself. And kind of what I wrote down is just, if you're busy, if you're having a busy day with your family, you're out and about, in the midst of the day, ask yourself, how am I feeling right now? Because ultimately, we want to find time for ourselves to feel good, a bit of me time. So just stop yourself in the day. Ask yourself, how am I feeling? Be kind to yourself. Don't beat yourself up if you haven't made time to exercise that day. And yeah, just address how you're feeling. And then within that day, you know, when you're cooking a meal for your family, again, going back to that whole ratio thing, if they're eating spaghetti with peas or whatever, why don't you switch that up, switch that ratio up, or add a bit more protein in for you? So just using that, so at least you're fueling your body in the right way through food, because most of the time we're all going to be cooking anyway, or making a choice with what we're going to be eating. So from that, that's one amazing way you can just make yourself feel good. Okay, you can give something else, or slightly give something different to your family, but what you're going to eat is just for you. And you're just know that you, just because someone else at the table is eating what they're eating, just know that what you're eating is going to make you feel better in yourself than eating what they're eating, if that makes sense. I think it does. I know it does to me. But yeah, I'm hoping that's coming across like it makes sense. So yeah, when you're cooking the meal, just ratios. Again, you might as well cook something healthy. I mean, there's so many great recipes out there for children, like children friendly and family friendly. And then just also with that, finding time for yourself, ask yourself, what is my goal? Do I want to be ripped? Do I want to be, you know, be doing 10 pull-ups, you know, with ease? Or do I just want to feel good? Do I just want to fit into my jeans, and that's it? So really just be realistic with what you actually want, because I find a lot of the time we put so much pressure on ourselves to be this person. Like, I've done it in the past as a personal trainer, like not with a six pack, not with washboard stomach, you know, on the slightly like higher fat side than maybe a PT that you'd see in a gym. I've put pressure on myself to have to be like that, and in turn it's only made me suffer, and that's caused more self-sabotage through guilt and shame than me just being happy as I am, feeling fit, feeling strong, but just maybe not looking as fit and strong as what I really am. And I've just had to be at peace with that and just be happy with myself. So again, if you're really busy and you're not finding the time for yourself, it's just being at peace with where you are right now and just being realistic with where you want to be. And then just knowing your worth as well, because worthiness comes into this. I am worth a few extra minutes of my time to make a slightly different meal for me, in accordance to my family. Or I am worth giving myself half an hour of the day just to go for a walk and have some me time, or to go and do a little workout in the park, or have a workout in the garden or in the living room, wherever. You are worth that time. And again, it's harder at the beginning, but the more you get into it, the easier it will get. And I know it's hard with kids. You can't really plan and schedule things in, but maybe if they have a decent early bedtime, then you can use the evening time to your advantage and use that time to work out, use that time to, don't know, do something that will serve you and your health and just make you feel good again. So I'm hoping that helps. And also just like, you know, I know it's summer holidays at the moment, so integrating your family activities into something more physical, something you can all enjoy, like a little mini hike or a walk or a cycle or just running around in the park. And just that being enough for you in your day to be like, okay, I've moved around, I feel good, you know, we all had a lovely time. So then that just being enough. So yes. And then the other thing to that question was also, you know, that mindset of life is too short not to enjoy, which is why I've said what I've said in terms of just being realistic with where you want to be and where you're at. Because life is too short not to enjoy. You know, you might want a bit of chocolate on a Monday night, and you know, you don't need to begrudge yourself a bit of these kind of little delights in the week, because you know, we're human, aren't we? And we all love a bit of sugar. So I just think, you know, balance it out. Again, goes back to that whole ratio thing. A higher ratio of healthy stuff, and then there's a little bit of leeway for the treats in your life. And there are so many ways you can do this. Like, portion control is obviously a huge one, and just again not having the guilt when it comes to chocolate and treats, ice cream, or whatever it is that you really like. For me, like, I love dark chocolate, so I buy like the little mini portioned ones, so that really works for me. You get like 5 in a pack, I think, and they're just mini portions, so I know that's basically like 2 squares of dark chocolate. Because if I buy a pack of like 100 grams of like dark chocolate, like Lindt or something, I know I'm probably going to eat like half at least in one sitting with a cup of tea. So yeah, for me, buying my portions really helps. But yeah, it's just things like that, little hacks that will help you to make the right decisions within your own little setup you've got going on. So yeah, and the same with exercise. So let me just touch on regular exercise. Somebody has asked, you know, how do you basically integrate regular exercise into your life? And I would just say, start off small, be realistic again. Are you really going to be doing 1 hour long gym sessions every day of the week? No, that's not realistic. If you've gone from doing nothing to wanting to do that, that's, you know, that's not feasible. And I think we all know it, don't we? So just start small, even just as small as doing 1 exercise session a week, but actually making it quite high intensity for you. It could just be a few squats, a few lunges, a few press ups, a bit of skipping, I don't know, whatever you can do, even in like 10 or 15 minutes or 20 minutes, half an hour. Doesn't have to be long. And again, it's going back to being okay with just doing something little, and again, not feeling guilty or not feeling like you need to be working out for longer, because it doesn't work like that. Just start small, be realistic, going on walks even, you know, if that's where you want to start, go on a nice walk in nature. That will do you the world of good. Like, honestly, if you're in a certain headspace, I mean, you go out in nature, you go for a walk, you come back, you just feel so much better about yourself, about life, about other people, and you're just going to feel good. So again, it's all going back, always going back to just feeling good in yourself. So yeah, that's pretty much what I've got to say about regular exercise. Find something you enjoy and then try your best to stick to it. And if it's not working, then try something else. But you got to keep trying. You really, really do. Because as soon as we stop, our ego says, "Oh yeah, this is where I'm comfortable. I like it here." And then it's not gonna push you. So you really have to use the power of your mind to push yourself when it comes to that. So yeah. All right. Next up, the last thing I'm gonna comment on and question is about smoking. Because you know, we all know, for many, many people, smoking is a big thing, getting in the way of being in optimal health, because most smokers started when they were young. And like, I've been surrounded by smokers all my life, and me not being a smoker, like, I can see the struggle people go through smoking and wanting to give up, trying to give up, giving up even for like a week or a month or even a few months, but then lo and behold, they will go back to smoking again. And back to square one. Oh, yeah, I want to give up smoking. And they just really struggle. And I get it. I really, really do get it. Like with any addiction, whether it be food, drugs, sex, smoking is really hard to give up for a lot of people. But again, it's all in the mind. And as everything is, and we are bloody powerful human beings, honestly, we are all connected and we have the power to literally do what we want through our thinking first. It always goes back to the mind first. So the first thing I'm going to say about smoking is, what do you identify as? Because if you identify as a smoker, you're going to find it a lot harder to quit, because that's been ingrained in you for however many years you've been smoking. People have said it to you, oh yeah, are you a smoker? Yes, I'm a smoker. That's a label you've given yourself. And whenever we give ourselves labels, whether it be depression, anxiety, it's like we amplify the problem, we amplify the struggle. And by not identifying as a smoker and just being in that neutral kind of identification of self, you're able to then free up that energy to allow you to even like just go there and allow yourself to visualize not being a smoker. Because a lot of the time, smokers that have been so ingrained in this habit find it so hard to visualize a life without smoking, because smoking is literally like chains. It's, you're not free, because even if you're on holiday and you're on a beach and I don't know, you have to, smokers have to smoke, they're gonna smoke. Or even, I don't know, wherever you are, say you're at a wedding and you wanna go out for a cigarette, like, I don't know, there's so many situations. But on the flip side, you know, smokers love smoking when they're celebrating. Smokers love smoking even when they're happy. It's not just when they're feeling sad or when they're feeling tired or low or stressed. They enjoy cigarettes, and I get it. But at the same time, by not even trying to give up smoking, what is your ego trying to prove? And you need to ask yourself, is it trying to prove me right or wrong by me not giving up? Because if you try to give up and then you fail, you're proving your ego right by basically unconsciously thinking you're going to fail anyway. I'm hoping you're getting what I'm saying, because a lot of the time it just does come down to the ego, and the ego playing tricks on us, saying, ah, you're not good enough to quit smoking, or you haven't got it in you to quit smoking, you're not powerful enough. But actually, we need to prove our egos wrong by just not identifying as a smoker, deciding how we want to feel, visualizing ourselves as free of smoking, free of nicotine, free of the need of it, and just asking yourself again, like, by me smoking the cigarette, what am I looking to gain? Like, what feeling do I not have right now but I'm gonna get once I've smoked it? And it's quite hard, because it's a chemical reaction in your body that is really the feeling, but underneath that there's another feeling, you know, and that feeling might be that feeling of, oh, smoking gives me an excuse not to really go for what I want, smoking gives me an excuse not to really be the person who I know I can be, smoking gives me the excuse to not really be at my optimal health and to not live life with more energy, so that it gives me the excuse then to not work out, it gives me the excuse to not then go the extra mile for my boss, etc, etc, etc. So yeah, so just asking yourself, you know, how do I want to feel? And also, this is a really interesting one. I was thinking about, remember the time before you started smoking. Try and remember the time where, you know, because again, most smokers started when they were young, either at school or in their 20s. So remember a time where you weren't smoking. You didn't have to pick up a cigarette a few times a day and smoke it. try and remember how that felt and reconnect with that feeling, because for so many people it's buried deep in their memories and experiences of just living a life free of cigarettes. So when you remember that feeling of like not having to wake up in the morning and have one straight away with your coffee or tea, you know, and actually just moving through your day without the need for it. So yeah, trying to remember that feeling, I think will help. Again, because I'm not a smoker, you might think, you know, well, how are you to, you know, say all this, but this does help with things like food addictions and things like that. So I do think it helps with smoking as well. And, you know, ultimately, to be harsh, just stop making excuses. That is the main thing. Like, stop making excuses, because you're putting yourself in victim mode if you are, you know, you're disempowering yourself majorly by making these excuses, you know. And one thing I will say, you know, when people say, you know, they've got a pack of cigarettes and they say, I'm going to quit when the pack runs out. That is, again, disempowering yourself. Why don't you quit when you've still got cigarettes in that pack? Because you're proving to your ego and to yourself that you are in control, because the cigarettes are right there in your bag or in front of you. But you've got the choice. Again, it goes back to choosing. I'm not going to smoke them, because it's my choice and because I'm powerful enough to do it. And that is going to empower yourself. It's going to increase your confidence in yourself to basically not smoke them. And I think just choosing not to, honestly, you will just start to feel more empowered. And it's kind of like that smug feeling of like, you know, I don't need them. And, you know, speaking to a friend who did quit a few years ago, she was saying to me, you know, one of the hardest things was, you know, when I was at work, I would suddenly not be smoking with all the other smokers at work. And I thought, oh yeah, that must be really, really hard, because if you're used to doing something together with other people and you're bonding over a cigarette, the same with when you're out and you're drinking and you might go out for a cigarette, it's kind of like losing that part of you and losing that connection with other people. And she was saying, you know, other people would then say, oh, you've changed. But it's about actually being focused and just really just framing the benefits all the time. Okay, no, I don't get to be with my friend smoking anymore, but I get to enjoy my life without a constant cough. I get to have more time in my day. I don't have cigarettes controlling my day and my life anymore. So keep reframing those benefits to yourself in order to just keep going, just keep it up, because when other people see you stopping as well, their faith in themselves could even increase, because they see you doing it, you're an inspiration to them. So it might even be a knock-on effect to them, and then they're becoming to you for advice, asking you, how do you do it? You know, what's your secret? And again, it's all in the mind. Just know how powerful you really, really are. I'll be repeating that, because honestly, everything is in the mind. Hey guys, I've got a couple more joining. Hope you're all well. And yeah, just a couple more things really to wrap up on smoking really. Just shift your focus. If you really want to stop smoking, shift your focus from, instead of, I can't have that cigarette, to not smoking, shift it to, I am giving my body a rest. I am giving my lungs more capacity. I'm giving my throat a rest. Because, you know, I can just imagine, and this is not very nice, but just imagine visualizing that smoke and that nicotine going down through your throat, into your lungs and into your body, and almost like to the point where you start to feel disgusted by this habit just because of the effects it's having in your body. So visualizing the really horrible stuff, and then visualizing the reverse. So by not smoking, you're visualizing your lungs going back to their normal color and capacity. Your scent even just being nicer, you know, not smelling like a smoker. And all these other benefits that come from quitting smoking, and visualizing just what else you can do with that time in your day, what else you can spend that money on, or how much money can you save by not spending your money on cigarettes, because I know it's expensive. So yeah, empower yourself. And also just if you are going to really, really seriously quit smoking, try your best not to make a big deal about it, not to complain to other people about, oh, you know, I have to quit smoking, or I'm trying to quit. You know, don't say I'm trying to quit, say I am quitting. And you don't need to tell everyone. You can kind of keep it to yourself and just keep going back to who you want to become and where you want to be in your life. So again, just back to empowering yourself, know that you've got this, and that's it. So yeah, that's it on smoking. I think I've covered everything, or I have covered everything. If anyone did have any more questions, then do let me know, and I'll answer them. Or if you've missed this live, you're on the replay, let me know if you've caught up. And if you do have any more questions based around your struggles with health, do let me know as well, because I can talk about health all day long. And I just think it's, you know, always coming back to our power, knowing our power, and go back to the mind. So with that, I will leave you, and thank you for watching, and have a great weekend, guys.